Hello, welcome to ISTQB Foundation Level Syllabus, and today we are going to identify typical objectives of testing. So about the objectives, we have already seen in the definition of testing stage, but now here we will discuss in depth about these objectives, and this is very important from the examination point of view also. So let's start with our topic. So the typical objective, the first objective is to evaluate the requirements, user stories, designs and codes. So we have to evaluate the documents which is provided by the customer or whichever document we have developed. Let's see an example. Suppose we got this requirement from the customer, and the requirement says, for a web page, when the login detail is given, the next page shall load in few milliseconds, and if login details are not correct, then show a pop-up. So this is the requirement. Once you read this particular requirement, what you have to do is you have to ask these questions. The questions are, how much time? Because what they have told you is few milliseconds, but what is the correct definition of this few milliseconds? What is customer's expectation? Do he want the next page to be loaded in 5 seconds, 10 seconds, or in some few milliseconds? So that is the question we have to ask to the customer. The second question could be, which page will load next? So what he is telling is, when the login details are correct, then we have to load the next page. But what will be the next page according to him? So what it should contain, that is what we have to ask. And one more question can come up is, what is the pop-up content? So here they are telling is, if login detail is not correct, then the pop-up should come up. But that pop-up will contain what type of information, that is not mentioned. So these, if we get all these type of doubts while evaluating the requirement, user story, design and code, then we have to ask all these questions and get it clarified here itself. Okay, so that is the objective of testing, first objective. Now going to the second objective, now we have to verify the specified requirement is fulfilled or not. So we have asked question to the customer, and customer has come up with the answer. So according to that, we have developed a requirement. For example, this is our requirement, that login is correct, then go to the next page. The next page shall be loaded in 500 milliseconds. The next page shall contain information about the personal information. If the login detail is not correct, pop-up will appear, and pop-up message will be password and user ID is incorrect. So that is what is the information we got from the customer. Now we have to see that, are we fulfilling this 5 requirement given by the customer or not, by looking into the document or requirements or all other work products. So that is what is the verification stage. Hope you have understood. Now after that, the third stage will be the validation stage. So here what we will be seeing is the test objective is fulfilled or not. So we have got all the clarification from the customer. We have seen that as per the document, as per the code, everything is fine. Now we have to see that whether we are meeting the customer's expectation or not, and how we will do it is with this example. So here we will not see all these things in a code. What we will do is we will go to the web page. We will provide the login details and password, and we will see that whether the next information coming is the personal information, and whether this transaction happened within 500 milliseconds or not. So those type of monitoring will be doing as a output. We will not see about each points, but as a whole we will check as a system. So that is called as a validation stage. So that is our third objective of testing. So hope these three objectives are clear. We have to evaluate the requirement, then we have to verify that whatever requirement are available, whether we are fulfilling it or not, and then we have to see that whether our system as a whole is working as per the customer's requirement or not. So that is the three objectives. Now going to the fourth objective, that is, we have to increase the level of quality in our product by finding more defects, or whichever mean, by putting a good process, testing process, and we have to see that the level of quality is maintained at each stage of the testing. Okay, the fifth stage is to prevent defect. So if you are in the first stage of testing, like if you are in the evaluation of this requirement, then you have to see that you are asking all the possible questions. If suppose you have not asked about the timing, then there is a chance that developer may assume the time and he will develop it, and customer is not happy with that. So we have to find those type of issue whenever we are checking in whichever stage. So that is what, if we find the defect in that particular stage, then it will not be passed to the next level, and that by doing that we will prevent the defects. And the last one and the most important one of the objective is finding or detecting the failures and defects in the system. So when we are verifying the documents, we will be finding the defects, and as a whole when we are checking, then we are finding a failure. So in verification stage we will be finding the defects, and in the validation stage we will be finding the failure. So this is it all about the objective of testing. And then Apart from these straight objectives, there are three more objectives which we will see now. So the first objective is providing information to the stakeholders, like how many test cases we have covered, how many test cases are still pending, or those type of metrics we have to provide it to the customer. Are there any major issue open? So by getting those information, customer will be able to plan his future activities. So that is why that information is very much important for the customer. Next one is to reduce the level of risk. So if we are doing our process, if our process is correct and if we are doing well in our testing, then by doing that, what we will do is we will reduce the risk of the product being getting failure in the operational use. So before that only we will be finding the defects and we will reduce the risk. We cannot say that we have totally avoided the risk, but we will, by doing this, we will reduce the risk by finding more defects. And last one is to check that whether we are meeting all the contractual requirement or not. So if we have committed with the customer that we will provide him 5 features, so are we providing him all 5 features or not? Apart from that, we have to see that whether we are not violating any legal requirement of that particular country. So if you are in America, then what you have to see is all the legal requirement of that particular country is followed or not. Or if you are in Germany, then you have to see that all the legal requirement of that particular company is fulfilled or not, because country will have a different legal requirements and rules. Then if you are following any standard like CMMI standard, or if customer is telling you to go with a ASPICE standard, then are we fulfilling those standards or not? Or the industry standards, like if you are in an automotive industry, then the standards are different. If you are in the avionics industry, then the standards are different. So are we following those standards or not? So these are also coming as an objective of our testing. Now we are done with the objective. So we will move to the next topic, that is, though those objectives are in general for all the testing, but these objectives are also context dependent. That means what type of testing you are doing, depending upon that, the objectives will change. For example, suppose you are doing a component testing and you are doing a acceptance testing. So in component testing, what is your objective is to find as many defects as possible, because this is one of the initial stage of testing. So our main purpose is to find as many defects as possible so that it is cost effective. Whereas if you are in the acceptance testing, it is almost like a last level of testing, and here our objective is not to find the defect, whereas we have to see that all the requirement which is given by the customer is fulfilled or not. So this is a test for the confirmation, whereas this is the test for the finding defects. So you can see that how the objective is changed. So here the objective is find as many defects as possible, but here the objective is to see that whatever we have implemented is as per the customer or not. Next is, here the objective is to increase the code coverage. So we have to test as many test cases as possible before giving it to the customer. So here the main idea is to increase the code coverage. Whereas in the acceptance testing, our main objective is to provide all the information to the stakeholder as early as possible. So those objectives which we have studied previously are all common, but when it comes to the testing or the type of testing, it will differ. So, but it will be from those objectives only. So finding the defects, increasing the code for the component testing, confirming and providing information to the stakeholder for the acceptance testing. So hope you have understood this particular part also, that testing is, or the objective of testing is, context dependent. Now we will summarize all the things which we have studied till now. So the objective was to evaluate the work product, such as requirement, user stories, design and code. So we have to evaluate the documents. Next is to verify whether all specified requirements have been fulfilled. So all the requirements which customer has given, whether we have fulfilled it or not. Now we have to see that we have to validate whether the test objective is complete and work as the user and the other stakeholder accept. So whatever we have developed, whether it is working as the customer want it to work or not. So that is what we have to check, and that is our objective. Next is to increase or to build the confidence in the level of quality of the test objective. So we have to increase the or build the confidence in that particular product. And to detect and prevent a defect. So we have to find as many defects as possible. That is the objective. And by doing that, what we will be doing is we will be preventing the defects passing on to the next stage. Next objective is to provide sufficient information to the stakeholder, especially regarding the level of quality of the test objects. So that is the next objective. And to reduce the level of risk of inadequate software quality. Example, previously identified or undetected failure occurring in the operation. So we have to avoid that if we are not finding the defect, it should not appear in the operations also. So before that only we have to find it out. That is the meaning. And the last one is that we have to see that all the contractual requirement is fulfilled, all the legal requirement is fulfilled, all the regulatory requirements are done, standards are followed. So all these things also we have to check. And at the end we saw that testing is context dependent. So depending upon what type of testing you are doing, you have to select the objective from this chart here. So that is it from the objective of testing, and I will see you in my next video. Until then, happy testing.